I can't find anything.
Hey there. Everything has a price. Take a look and make me an offer. Give me a shout if you need anything else. Whatever.
Just like a little bitch.
What do you need? A pleasure doing business with you. Bye.
And my stalwart, cool manservant Argyle.
Yes.
Today's episode, Escape from
Paradise
there.
Falls.
So, little thing, boss.
I have a few things. May as well sell them to you as cart them all the way back to Megaton.
There, now for yours. Stand still. Argyle, you magnificent bastard. You did it. Don't thank me yet, boss. We still need to get out of here. Let's go, while the guard's away from the front gate. Not so fast, my flesh-rotten friend. That girl we came in with, we're the only chance she's got. Come on! Always with the dames. All right, she's locked in there. They call it
yeah.
The box. First, we need to remove that guard. Allow me. Hey, fella. Now the door. Child's play, boss. Okay, lady, you're rescued. Now let's get out of... What? Boss, it's empty. Hands up, chumps. Nobody escapes from Paradise Falls. Now let's move back to the pen. Nice and slow before...
Drop the steel, you slaver scumbag. You boys all right? I busted out of that box and was almost home free when I noticed your predicament.
Wait a minute. We do the rescuing around here, sister. Now, now, Argyle. No need to be hasty. We owe this young lady our thanks, Miss...
Penelope Chase, fortune hunter. You can buy me a beer later. Now let's cut this shindig short and get the bloody hell out of here. Come on.
Argyle, old friend, I think I'm in love. Time for another exciting adventure of me, Herbert Daring Dashwood, and my stalwart cool manservant Argyle.
And now some music.
I don't want to set the world on fire.
Another set. Whatever. What? Who? You mean, are you for real? I'm safe? I need to get out of here. Here, take these supplies. It's all I have, but they'll only slow me down. Okay, if you say so. I can't thank you enough, stranger.
Ah, fellow student on the path of the wasteland. Welcome to my humble caravan. Please relax, for we are in a place of safety. The type of safety that can only be ensured by an abundance of weaponry, both wicked and awesome, all of which can be yours for the right price. Until we meet again, looking for that special something? See, the world's a dangerous and unbalanced place. So I realized the only way to bring peace was to make sure that everyone could be dangerous. So, with a little bit of help from the mayor of Canterbury Commons, I set up this caravan. I can't give the weapons away for free, but I come close. It's my pleasure to offer hot death in a variety of exciting flavors. Take your pick. Thanks. Until we meet again, keep yourself alive out there.
Good to see you.
Please, do you have any water? I'm so thirsty. I've been drinking this irradiated shit, and I can't do it. I just throw it up now. I need purified water. Please! You mean you don't want anything for it? I don't have any caps or anything. I can just have it for free? Water. Oh, precious water. Thank you. You're a saint.
Welcome to Rivet City. Please wait while the bridge extends.
Hold it right there. State your business in Rivet City. Is that so? All right, you're free to roam around, so long as you don't do anything stupid, like try to slit my throat when I'm sleeping. You wouldn't try anything stupid like that, now would you? We're the safest, most secure city in the wasteland. Nothing can get in here without our say-so. I suppose. The door on the left goes to the stairwell. From there, just keep heading west. I suppose. Hangar deck, right in the middle of the ship. Can't miss it. But it's closed now. Check back in the morning. It opens pretty early. I suppose. Dr. Preston is in the upper deck, fore section. That's the top interior floor in the southwest end. The common room is free, but the beds are lousy. It's on the midship deck. A big open room with lots of beds. You can't miss it. If you want to sleep well rested, rent a room from Vera Weatherly. She's on the upper deck. Carry on, then.